just like a dream to me. That's so happy.
Yeah. I found love in you. And I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you.
Welcome, everyone. It is my absolute pleasure to be able to perform this ceremony. It was uniquely written for just Joshua and Candace. I'd like to ask that if you please could turn your cell phones off or put them on vibrate so that there are no interruptions, please. Who gives this one away? Again, welcome. You have all come today to witness and celebrate the drawing together of two separate lives. Again, this was uniquely written, so we're not going to deviate. I'm going to try my best to not deviate. We have come so that Candace and Joshua may celebrate and consecrate their spiritual union. It is by their love and that of God that they will be united here today. And they wish to celebrate this passage in the presence of your love and support, and to share their joy in each other with you, their family, and their friends. Love is perhaps the most profound experience we can have. The sensual part of love is one of life's greatest joys. And when this is combined with real friendship, both are infinitely enhanced. The day-to-day companionship, the pleasure in doing things together or in doing separate things, but delighting to exchange experiences, is a continuous and the central joy that those in love share together. Deep knowledge of another is not something that can be achieved in a short time, and real understanding of the other's feelings can develop fully only with years of intimacy. This is wonderful knowledge of another person grows out of truly caring for the other so much that one wants to understand as completely as possible what the other is feeling. Thus, it is impossible to share not only joys and successes, but also the burden of sorrows and failures. To be known in this way is a priceless thing, because such understanding and acceptance makes it easier to live with profound intimacy. It can and must also enhance the individual strength of each other. We must give ourselves in love, but we must not give ourselves away. Joshua and Candace, face each other, please. Your union offers you the highest and most intimate experience of love that we know. A growing bond of affection, trust, and mutual concern can bring you into a fuller life that either of you can never achieve alone. As you share with each other your individual differences, your life together can become richer, more complete, and more spiritually satisfying. A union in such a sense will entail a uniting on all the levels of your being, body, and mind, heart, and spirit. Then the longer that you are together, the more you grow and develop together, the deeper your lives will be together in one union. Even now, love is calling for the best qualities deep within each of you, seeking to break down barriers of fear, selfishness, or anything that would keep you apart. The love opens a way of understanding and sensitivity and courage, enabling you to be more responsive to the desires and needs of one another. Remember always that love, loyalty, and trust are the foundations of a lasting and happy union. As you strive to fulfill the commitment that you declare to one another here, your life together can be increasingly full of joy, satisfaction, and peace. I pray that you will hold fast to the vision and promise of this day. Candace, do you take Dr. Joshua as your partner in life, promising to dearly, tenderly care for him, to respect his individuality, to cherish him as he is, to love him with fidelity?
Yes, I do.
Joshua, do you take Candace as your partner in life, promising to dearly and tenderly care for her, to respect her individuality, to cherish her as she is, to love her with fidelity? I, Candace, take you, Joshua.
I, Candace, take you, Joshua.
To be my beloved partner in life. To stand with you always. In times of celebration. In times of sorrow. In times of joy. And in times of pain. In times of sickness. In times of health. I will live with you, love you, cherish you, as we both shall live. Repeat after me. I, Joshua, take you, Candace.
I, Joshua, take you, Candace.
To be my beloved partner in life.
To be my beloved partner in life.
To stand with you always.
To stand with you always.
In times of celebration.
In times of celebration.
In times of sorrow.
In times of sorrow.
In times of joy.
In times of joy.
In times of pain.
In times of pain.
In times of sickness. And in times of health, I will live with you, love you, and cherish you, as long as we both shall live. Please hold each other's hands. So that you may see the gift that is always there for you. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on this day, as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief temporarily comes to you. These are the hands that will countless times wipe your tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children, the hands that will join your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it, support and encouragement and comfort through difficult times. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Can we have the rings, please?
Thank you.
Joshua, in giving you this ring, I join my life with yours and pledge my everlasting love. Joshua, repeat after me. Candace, in giving you this ring, I join my life with yours and pledge my everlasting love. Place the ring on her finger. And now it's time for the United Podcast. You're each going to grab a candle and light the one. And Joshua, these two candles now lit before you symbolize each of you and your individual uniqueness. The larger candle is to symbolize the power and the vision of your union together. Each of you has brought to this moment a wealth of personality, of background, and of experience and strength and weakness. And as you each bring all of these to your union, you will be lighting a new candle together.
Yes.
Using the fire that each of you brings in this place and this decision. But do not extinguish your individual lights. I'm going to repeat that. Do not extinguish your individual lights. At least there be less light and warmth. May these flames burn brightly and the warmth of your love of each other and each other be greater. Guest. Joshua and Candace will turn to each of you for support, love, and guidance in the years to come. Will each of you do all that is in your power to encourage them and commitment to support them? If so, say I will.
I will.
Ladies and gentlemen, by the power vested in me and the state of Ohio, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Taylor. You may kiss your bride.
It's my dog.
Thank you.
Rise and exit down the middle aisle.